There's actually a lot of classical music out there, a lot of really weird stuff like this. And I think it's really interesting to sort of expand your view of what we can do with this kind of stuff. And I think if we engage people on a different level with some weird stuff, maybe the perception will change a little bit. Comments? Y'all are better too. Yeah.
The movements I thought were interesting is that the open and closed, the key or cover, and like the animal presence.
Yeah.
Which is interesting, and maybe it reminded me that as other artists performed, there was movement and interaction, and there was more feeling. And I guess every performance of silence is a little bit different, and maybe it's just more muted in its expression physically as well.
Yeah.
Made me think, I guess.
That's good. I think that's really the point of it. Yeah, I thought it was a tease. Like, I was like, oh, he's about to like do something. So I was waiting to hear like, you know, some more sounds and stuff. But I see what he's trying to do. He's trying to make a point, you know, like sounds all around us. But I know, yeah, I think that's the best part of the movements, is that when he opens the fall board again, you're like, what's going to happen? And then nothing goes. Just a little bit of letdown. Okay. This is, yes?
I'm just wondering if anybody had any music going on in their heads.
Oh, that's a good question.
Any what?
Like, did you have, like, a tune that you were thinking about, Gabe?
No, I was actually pointing at the trumpet that was playing up
there. That's true.
I heard some good conversations out there.
That's good. Excellent. Any other thoughts?
Yeah.
Yes.
I feel and have feelings around the noisy world we live in. There was a discussion about traffic noise. That's very agitating to me because I grew up in a very rural kind of quiet area. And so I love the song of silence. I love silence and prayer, contrasting to the music that I love too. It was always down and always music.
Absolutely. I agree. I think it makes you appreciate the rest of the concert. It really makes you engage more because you have something to grab onto finally. Okay. Last call for comments. Anybody else? Brenda, yeah.
Yeah, I'm really glad you included this in concert. I think it's a good philosophical contrast to what we normally would perceive as music. If I have melodies, I have a strategy, this and that. We have this sort of, I guess, criterion that we have re-established for music, and this makes you kind of question. They will really, is there a definition to music? You know, what's our personal definition? And I don't know, I thought this was great.
Cool. I liked it. I think it brings up a good point that there's more to music than just notes. There's a lot of philosophy and thought behind it. And you might not understand it at first, but these composers have put a lot of thought into it. To publish this music, it takes some guts if that's going to be a compromise. Yeah.
It's interesting you say that because the trying to get in the composer's head about what their piece means, what their sounds mean, and the piece that you just included, the silent piece, was written by a guy who just said he doesn't seem to care about the composer's intentions, he doesn't seem to care about the meaning of the sounds himself. So the fact that his piece, his work that kind of inside, is interesting, not conflictual.
Yeah, that's a good point. Okay, we're going to move on to some more actual notes. So, Bach is next.
I started viola in fifth grade. I just wanted to get out of music class in general, and then I had this outlet to go do strings, as it was called, and my cousin played viola, I just decided to go ahead and choose viola.
Did your parents ever have to push you to practice, or did you get into it?
Definitely had to push me to practice a lot. No kid wants to sit down and hack away at something like that. Of course, all I wanted to do was just grab it and play, Beethoven or something like that, but right off the bat, there's no way I could have done that. So they had to push me a lot.
So how much do you practice per day now?
per day now. I'm expected to practice 4 hours per day. I usually try to get that in and everything, but don't always quite meet 4 hours a day, sometimes more.
Do you get nervous when you perform?
You know, not so much anymore. Especially in the orchestra setting, I used to get way, way too nervous through that, but I don't know, I think I've done it so many times now that it's kind of just a second nature thing, and I really just love performing, you know. I love being able to present a final final outcome, I guess, to what I've been working on.
What's your favorite part about the pieces that you've written?
My favorite part about the pieces I'm going to play? Well, the Allemande is very dance-like. I love the energy in it. It's very playful, not too serious or anything like that. The Sarabande is the complete opposite direction, you know, very slow, not something you can dance to. It technically is a dance, but really it's more for, it seemingly is more for just expression and other things. So it's kind of the best of both worlds.